yeah.
Drummer Dave Rahab here, and in today's video, I'm going to teach you the number 4 drum video of the 40 International Drum Rudiments, otherwise known as the Multiple Bounce Roll, or also called Buzz Roll. You have to work on both hands separately before you can do them together. I'm going to show you on your grip how you're going to grip it between your thumb and your index finger, otherwise known as the fulcrum. That's where the majority of your pressure and balancing point is going to be coming from when doing this roll. Your other 3 fingers, you'll wrap around the stick. But as you can see here, there's room for the stick to move in there. It's not really touching these fingers. You're leaving the stick freedom, and it's all coming from the pressure point of your fulcrum. And then you're going to simply just throw it down on the pad or your drum, and you're going to vary the degree of how much pressure you're putting on your fulcrum here. So if it's looser, you can get a lot more bounces. Then if it's tighter, it's going to force the stick into the head. And create that multiple bounce. There's no set amount, so you don't have to worry about counting them out. And then also the same thing in your left hand. You want to find and you can try different amounts of pressure. I'm not gripping it real hard between my thumb and my index finger. The stronger my grip is and the tighter I clench it there, I'm forcing the stick to bounce at a faster rate just by throwing it down with one motion and squeezing between my fulcrum. You're just going to be going right, left, right, left, right, left, right, and then practice just pressing the stick into the head. As you get going faster, get the gap closer. So the idea is to keep it real even between both hands, same pressure. That takes a little bit of practice, but just keep practicing. You can also practice different tempos between your drumsticks. Even though you're doing a roll, it's going to be going real fast. Or da 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 da. So practice the tempo of between your right and your left hands, doing just straight singles and then buzzing them and try and get them to sound completely even. And get rid of that little gap between the hands and make it sound as even as possible. When you're doing long rolls, like you do in concert bands and like when you're playing like the national anthem, you know, where you're just dun, 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 you know, and you're rolling for like forever, it feels like. The important part is try and stay as relaxed as you can in your wrists and your arms, because as soon as you start cramping up going for a long period of time, you're gonna be in pain, you're not gonna be able to roll. Just a little tip, tricks, try these different things, different tempos, different speeds, different dynamics, and just keep working at it. It takes a little time in the beginning. I remember this being one of the harder things I had to learn when I first started drumming, but just stick with it, be persistent, and just keep working at it, and it will get better and better and better. You get out of it what you put into it. Thank you for hanging out with me today. This has been your quick drum rudiment of the day. Drummer Dave Rahab signing out. And I'll see you in the next one.